हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 6.5। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 सेज फाइंड द पेरीमीटर ऑफ द रेक्टेंगल हुज लेंथ इज 40 सेंटीमीटर एंड अ डायगोनल इज 41 सेंटीमीटर। सपोज दिस इज द रेक्टेंगल, से दिस इज ए बी सी डी, ओके, and the length of the rectangle is given, which is 40 centimeters. Suppose this is the length, okay, and the diagonal is 41. Now diagonal can be AC also, BD also, as it is same in a rectangle. So let us consider AC diagonal, which is 41 centimeter, okay. Now we will have to find the perimeter. Perimeter means the boundary. So the perimeter of a rectangle is 2 into length plus breadth, means this is the length of the rectangle and this is the breadth of the rectangle. So when you'll find the sum of this, the sum of L and B, and when you'll multiply by 2, you'll get the perimeter of the rectangle. Now here only we know the value of L because length is given, breadth is not given. This is the breadth, okay, of a rectangle, which is not given. So what we have to do, we will have to find the value of B at first, then only we can find the perimeter. Now see here, this rectangle is divided into two parts. This rectangle is divided into two parts and each part is the shape of a triangle. Now here 90 degrees formed. Why? Because we know that each angle in a rectangle is 90 degree. Okay. Now here we have to find the value of BC. We know the value of AB and AC. Using Pythagoras theorem, we can get the value of BC. And after getting the value of BC, we can easily put in this place to get the perimeter. Okay, so we'll write in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC by Pythagoras theorem, the square of the longest side. Now, which one is the longest side over here from this triangle? From the triangle ABC, which one is the longest side? 90 degrees formed at B point, and opposite of 90 degrees is the longest side. So here longest side is AC. So we'll write square of AC is equals to the square of the sum of the other two sides. Other two sides are AB and BC. So we'll write AB square plus BC square. Now we know the value of AC, so we'll put in place of AC, so it's 41 square. Now AB is 40 square. BC we don't know, so BC will remain same. Okay. Now 41 square means 41 into 41. 40 square means 40 into 40 plus BC square. Now 41 into 41, how much? It's 1 1's are 1, 4 1's are 4, 4 1's are 4, 4 4's are 16. So it's 1, 4 plus 4, 8, 6 will come down and 1 will come down. So it's 1681. Okay, now 40 into 40, so here we have 2 zeros, so we'll put 2 0 and 4 4's are 16. So we have 1600 if you multiply 40 by 40 plus BC square. Now since we'll find the value of BC square, so we'll just take the value, we'll just take 1600 on left hand side. So it will be 1681 minus 1600 is equals to BC square. Now if you subtract 1600 from 1681, then we'll be getting 1 and 8 81. So BC square is equals to 81. Now we will have to find the prime factors of 81. So prime factors of 81 is, it can go by 3 because the sum of the digit, when you find the sum of the digit, 8 plus 1 is 9 and 9 is divisible by 3, so it's 3, 2's are 6, 3, 7's are 21, 3, 9's are 27, 3, 3's are 9 and 3, 1's are 3. Okay, so BC square means BC into BC, and 81, prime factors of 81 is 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Now from the pair we'll take 1, so we'll have 1 BC. Now from this pair we'll take 1 and from this pair we'll take 1. So the value of BC will be 9 centimeter. Now BC is here, BC is the breadth. BC means breadth. So after getting the breadth, in place of B, if we put the value of B, then we can easily get the perimeter of the rectangle, okay, which is 2 into length plus breadth. So we'll write perimeter of the rectangle is 2 into length plus breadth. Now here length is 40, okay, so we'll write 40 in place of L, and breadth we have got just now, which is 9, so we'll put 9 in place of B. Now 2 multiplied by 40 plus 9 is 49, so 2 multiplied by 49 is 9 2's are 18, 8 1 carry, 4 2's are 8, 8 plus 1 9, so it's 98 centimeter. The perimeter of the rectangle is 98 centimeter. Okay, so this was all about question number 7. Now coming to question number 8. Now question number 8 says the diagonals of a rhombus measure 16 centimeter and 30 centimeter. Find its perimeter. The length of the diagonal is given. The diagonal of the rhombus AC and BD is given 16 centimeter and 30 centimeter. Say this is the rhombus ABCD. Okay, BD and AC are the diagonals. Let the shorter diagonal BD 16 centimeter and the larger one AC. Here we have two diagonals. One is shorter, another is bigger. Okay, so let us consider the length of BD is 16 centimeter, means length of the diagonal BD is 16 centimeter and the length of the diagonal AC is 30 centimeter. Now we have to find the perimeter. So perimeter means the boundary, the length of all four sides we will have to find. And since the length of all four sides in a rhombus are equal, so to get the perimeter we will have to just multiply by 4. Okay, to get the perimeter of a rhombus we will just multiply by 4. But here side is not given, so here we will use Pythagoras theorem to find the length of the side. Okay, because the diagonals in a rhombus bisect each other at 90 degrees. Okay, diagonals in a rhombus bisect each other at 90 degrees. Okay, that means AC, here if you consider as O, AOD is also 90 degrees, AOB is also 90 degrees, BOC is also 90 degrees, and COD is also 90 degrees. Okay, now diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other means each diagonal cuts the other into two equal halves. That means the length of OA will be equal to the length of OC. This length and this length will be equal since it cuts the other into two equal parts. Okay, so OB means the length of OB will be equal to the length of OD. So the length of BD is 16 centimeter. So what will be the half of this? It's 8 centimeter. So the length of OD will be 8 centimeter. Similarly, the length of AC is 13 centimeter. So what will be the length of OA? It will be half of 30 and half of 30 is 15. Okay. Now, here this is 90 degree. And opposite of 90 degree, this is the longest side. So if you take this triangle, okay, if you take this triangle as this is the right angle triangle, so we can apply Pythagoras theorem over here. And using Pythagoras theorem, we can find the value of AD. And if we get the length of AD, then in a rhombus all sides are same. So we can easily find the perimeter of a rhombus. Okay, so we'll write in triangle AOD, we will have to mention the triangle here. So in triangle AOD, here AO is half of 30. So the length of AO is 15 centimeter, and the length of OD is 16 divided by 2, it's 8 centimeter. Now we will have to use Pythagoras theorem to find the value of AD. Now this is 90 degree, and opposite of 90 degree is the longest side. According to Pythagoras theorem, the square of the longest side. So here what we have found, that AD is the longest side. So the square of AD will be the sum of the square of the other two sides. Here other two sides are OA square, or we can write AO square plus OD square. Now AO is 15 square and OD is 8 square. So here 15 square means 15 into 15, and 8 square means 8 into 8. So AD square is equals to 15 into 15, 225, plus 8 into 8, 64. Now we'll add this to 225 plus 64. So 5 plus 4, 9, 6 plus 2, 8 and 2. So it's AD square is equals to 289. Now we will have to find the prime factors of 289. Now 289 comes only 17 steps. Okay, it cannot be divisible by 2, 3, 4. It is directly divisible by 17. So 17 is 289, and 17 ones are 17. So AD square means AD into AD, and factors of 289, prime factors of 289 is 17 into 17. Now from the pair we will have to take one. So from here we have taken one AD, and from here we'll take 170. Okay, so the length of AD is 17 centimeter. So the length of AD is 17 centimeter. Now since in a rhombus all sides are equal, so AB is also 17 centimeter, BC is also 17 centimeter, and CD is also 17 centimeter. Now we will find the perimeter. So perimeter of a rhombus is 4 into side. So here each side is 17 centimeter. So 4 multiplied by 17. Okay. So it's 68 centimeter. Perimeter of a rhombus is 68 centimeter. So this was all about question number 8. Thank you, students.